Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at editing photos in iOS 8 and also adding third-party photo extensions. So let's take a look at this on an iPhone 5S. And things look pretty similar on all devices. I notice things like, for instance, on the iPad, some of these controls are on the opposite side. Let's edit this old photo here. I'm going to hit the Edit button. And some of these things look familiar from the old Photos app in iOS 7 and before, and also in the iPhoto app. For instance, in the upper left hand corner, you can see the magic wand, the automatic enhance button. I tap that and it's going to change a few things to try to optimize the picture. It's always a good idea to try that just to see what it does. Now let's look at some of the buttons on the right. So we have the cropping button, which also allows you to rotate the picture. So you can see I can grab a corner and I can crop the photo. I can drag the photo around in that frame area. Hit that reset button there to reset it. I also have this, the angles here on the right, and I can tap on the right there and rotate the image. Now what it's going to do when you bring up a photo for the first time is it's going to try to automatically rotate the image. It'll look for any straight lines in the photo and try to figure out if the photo is a little bit off and try to maybe put it in a better kind of angle. So you may see that automatically do something as soon as you go to crop. You've also got the ability using that square with the arrow at the top to rotate by 90 degrees, such as that. And then at the bottom there, you can see you can set the format here. So for instance, if I wanted to make this a square photo, I can make it square there. And I can still drag within to change this, and as I move the box now, it's going to stay square. I can always hit the reset button to go back. So it's very easy to play with this and see what you can do and not have to worry about trying to get back to step one. Now let's look at the second button on the right, and this will bring up filters. And you can try all sorts of different filters there and just switch between them just to see what they can do for you. And you can go up to none to cancel that. Now the third button there allows you to adjust things and fine-tune things. You've got three different types of controls. Like for instance, under light, if I tap that, you can see I can change all sorts of different things. So I can just go right for the exposure, or I can try to do something more subtle like changing the shadows. And then I could bring this meter up or down just by sliding it with my finger here. I can bring these controls back here and try to change the contrast as well, so you can adjust multiple ones to get what you want. I can close light there and go to color. And under color here, I can drag this to adjust the color like that. But I could also go to, say, something specific like saturation there or cast. And then finally, I've got black and white options here. So there's a lot here I can do with the black and white. And I can change things like intensity, neutrals, tone, grain. So you can play with all of these different things to get the photo exactly like you want. There's basically almost infinite possibilities because there's so many different settings and so many different ways that you can set them. Now let's look at adding extensions. You don't have to just stick with the filters that are there in the Photos app. You can add new ones. Now, the only one I've been able to find so far in the early days here of iOS 8 is an app called Fragment, and you can see it at the bottom right there. So I've gone to the App Store, I've purchased that for $2, and I installed it. Now that I've done it, let's go back to editing and edit this photo again. And notice there's your new button on the bottom left. There are three dots there. I tap that, and there's going to be nothing in it right now except the More button. I tap More, and it'll show me the apps that have extensions for this app. So the apps that have extensions for photos. And the same thing will happen. You do the same process basically if you're looking for extensions in Safari. You're in the Safari app. You look for that button with the three dots and you get to here. And in this case, I'm going to enable Fragment here as a photo editor. And now I can see when I hit those three dots, I can bring up, I get that Fragment right there. And now there's my photo, and I can use the filters here in Fragment to do all sorts of different weird things with my photo. So, and of course, this is just one example. It's pretty much a fully functional part of the app, but I'm still in the Photos app. So once I get something I like, so let's do this one here, I get it done, and you can see I'm still in my Photos app, but it's made the changes. I think over the coming months we're going to see tons of different third-party apps that add more filters and functionality to photo editing in both the Photos and the Camera app. An app that actually adds stuff right now to video editing is iMovie. If you have Apple's iMovie, the most recent version for iOS 8, you have those three dots and are able to do some iMovie editing inside of the Photos app when you edit a video. So you may want to check that out as well. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost.com.